Hey guys, I just want to say thank you for clicking on this video, and if you notice my voice being a little bit quiet in the gameplay, there's a reason for it. I was trying to make the gameplay a little bit more louder than my voice, so that when something would jump out or something would happen, it'd be a little bit more louder and probably jump you guys better as well. So if you guys want me to kind of keep it this way, or if you want me to put a little bit more voice into it or a little less, just let me know and I'll do it. How you guys doing today? It's Thankless here, back with another video. Today we're playing Kona. I haven't really watched any videos on this or gameplay on this yet. I kind of wanted to save it and play it myself. So you guys are seeing my first impressions of this game. I've been waiting really long for this game to come out full. I didn't really want to play it in between like beta and stuff like that, because I just wanted to experience the full game. So let's get right into it. I'll try and stay quiet during audio and I guess cutscenes or whatever, so let's get right into it. If it'll load. It's a nice truck.
Carl Flaubert sought information for a living. That is to say that ever since he returned from Korea, after having served with the armed forces, he had been working as a private investigator in Montreal. William Hamilton, a rich industrialist, had gotten in touch with him regarding a simple vandalism issue. Nothing to write home about. Not worth hiring a private eye either, just so he can drive for hours on rough roads. But that's how it had always been. The client pays, Carl gets it done.
So that's gas, brake, reverse,
brake. They had set up to meet at the general store, his client's business. Well, actually, the entire village had William Hamilton's name written all over it.
40 miles an hour, that's too bad.
Were bad, muddy, or snowed in, it was customary around these parts to close them off. But it was also customary to ignore those signs entirely and drive there anyway.
Alright, so we're gonna be trespassing now, I guess. What's going on here? Flyer. It will be good. I don't know about that. Check the gate.
Hamilton never mentioned a road-blocking barrier. Why was it needed here in the back of beyond? That would, however, be a mystery for another day. Carl had waited long enough for someone to come and raise it. Still not a soul in sight. There was no point in waiting any longer. Carl had to figure this one out by himself.
Well, that's not creepy at all. Let's go up here, I guess. That's the only other place we can go.
Emperor Duplessis, in spite of his conservative agenda, did a good job in colonizing the rural north, which helped to re-establish the region as an integral part of the province of Quebec. The blue fleur-de-lisée could be seen fluttering in the wind here and there, taunting the red Canadian flags on the other side of the province's boundaries. Hamilton is waiting for Carl in the general store. It was time for him to get down to business.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Let's get her going.
Hi.
William Hamilton enjoyed a lavish country house built in the very heart of the northern forests, not too far from here. The local populace was divided when it came to the affluent man. Some saw a wealthy philanthropist dedicated to improving the region's economy. Others an aging Englishman who would do anything to further his fortunes. And those ones hated him enough to go on about scheming against him. Hamilton had recently acquired a few local businesses, but the last straw was the reopening of a mine, which gave rise to a wave of protests and threats from the Cree people. Given these circumstances, Carl reckoned that a good number of people must be feeling compelled to oppose Hamilton in one way or another. So far, only the industrialist's house had been a target, but soon enough, Carl thought, the target would become the man.
Boom. That's where when it all begins, I guess. I don't know, have you guys played this game yet? How are you guys enjoying it? Because, I don't know, might be making a series on this, because I don't think I can play all this in one playthrough.
Carl needed to get out of there. The cold and the pain required urgent care.
We're stuck.
Had taken off. It was still best to check it out and leave nothing to chance. Carl needed help. It was a small, locked box engraved with the letters WH. Carl thought about taking it. Nothing was to be left to chance.
Anything else? Can we check the engine, maybe?
This deep in the country, his last hope was to find an abandoned garage or a farm by the roadside. His life depended on it.
Bring the tailgate down. Oh, shit. Take anything out? Oh, let's take the fire starter out. Alright. We're just gonna leave the truck running here or something, I guess. Turn it off.
It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore.
Looks promising. South Anthony Apex. I think I said that right. Stress. Got a log.
Better than he had hoped. Carl Faubert had succeeded once more, and was now on his way to new adventures.
Matches, fire starter. Start this fire. Okay, so we save every time we start a fire, I guess. That's convenient. Oh, that's not good. Else in here we can steal? It looks like something I would want to steal right there. No, I can't take it. Let's go check this tower back here. I'm stressing out, man. Let's check up here. Someone's doing some donuts out here. Might as well go check that too once we get done up here. There's probably nothing. And there is nothing. Awesome. Let's see this. see no point in it though. It's under there. Huh. I thought I was standing torch or something to light on fire. Well, let's go get these chains back on the truck and let's see if we can get it out. Whose footprints are these guys? Someone's been here. Whose are these? Oh no, someone's following me. Nah, I'm just kidding. Just in this chair. Alright, so how do I get... There we go, that's how you might inventory consumables. Polaroid film. Which I haven't seen one of those cameras in a long time. It's crazy. 11 matches. 3 fire starter. A log. Let's go back. Check the map. Right there. Pretty sure that's where I'm gonna die, is somewhere right there. Probably. Huh. Let's see what else we got. Equipment. We got a flashlight. Camera, map, journal. Let's get the flashlight out. The torch. Alright, well. Let's go get that truck out of there now since I healed myself. That's not good.
Spread out on a few acres of untouched forest, bellowing caribou, everlasting snow, and undefiled lakes, the Manistan region was no tourist hub. It was said to have been populated for millennia by Cree people, and ever since the industrial era, by the metal mining industry. Running on fumes. Good thing that the general store was close by.
Called it. No. Loading the screen. So glad it stopped snowing here where I live. So glad. Oh, this would suck though. Look at this.
The pumps wouldn't surrender their divine nectar so easily. In all likelihood, they had to be switched on from inside the store.
Right.
A milkman had to drive by every week to fill the bottles. The fresh milk indicated a recent visit. A milkman had to drive by every week to fill the bottles. The fresh milk indicated a recent visit. Something fell to the bottom of the box.
just don't look good.
Carl had no trouble recognizing his employer. He had been killed. There was no need to be a detective to figure that out. But only a detective could have noticed that the killer had to have been very close. That the fatal blow had been given before the victim even realized.
I'm gonna just take some pictures of this. Sorry about this, man. Got a hobby of taking pictures of dead people, sorry about that. Pretty good photo right there. What's this?
What could be inside that envelope? Carl was taken aback. He knew this address. It was said to be the address of the P.O. box for the Canadian Secret Service.
Oh. Canadian Secret Service. We don't need that right now. Come on, let me take this. Coca-Cola. Oh my goodness. I guess that's one way to get around there, right?
An explosion suddenly occurred outside.
That's not good. Lights. All right. Oh shit.
Carl knew that Gilles Lachance was in charge of the general store. That made him one of Hamilton's employees. A very angry employee, as Carl could plainly see.
Some music, come on. Oh, what's that? Oh, what's this? This place is a mess. Really? Someone just died right there and that's all you can think of? What's this? Oh, it's the same thing that I already read. Let's go out. Oh, damn.
Maintaining his composure, Carl recalled something from his military training. Wolves always stay away from populated areas. Wait, was it about bears? Carl was no electrician, but he could identify a wiring problem when he saw one. Carl was used to strange phenomena, but a chunk of ice like this, as if an iceberg came out of the ground, that was a first.
Let's keep
prints?
That one.
Carl found a surprise at every turn. Was the camera faulty, or was there a possible lead? Hate was in the air. Seems like some villagers barely tolerated each other.
Huh. Well, let's go back inside and see if we can find that key. Flash that out. open cash register, punch the price two numbers minimum. Price sell, turn the crank two times, punch the machine if it don't work. Alright, I'll do that. Oh, post office.
Amateur hunters showing some pride at having killed a nice pelted beast. With men like this roaming the area, wolves would become extinct within 10 years, Carl thought.
No thanks, I ate too many of these in Korea. What are they, MREs? Huh. Hey sir, do you know where the key's at? For the garage out back? Maybe there's drawers in here? Oh yeah, there are. Nothing in there. Oh.
According to that log, it seemed like the whole village owed some money to the general store. Carl was far more interested in the bunch of nearby addresses he had just gotten his hands on, though.
Ooh, garage key. That's what we need. No, I don't need that.
The snowstorm pummeled everything in its path. Carl was not surprised when he heard no tone. Carl was no electrician, but he could identify a wiring problem when he saw one.
What kind of PI doesn't go anywhere without a gun, you know? That's what I need. Let's address this place before we leave. Does radio work? Yeah. Just turn that off. At least we know it's fragile. As it falls down, that'd be funny. Nothing over here. Guess not.
Staring intently at the controls won't be enough to make that lift budge. The poor thing was out
Dang
of power.
It. That's what I was hoping would happen. Oh, I thought I saw a health pack. Still none. Oh wait, what's this? Ooh, bottle of wine. Let's go get hammered right now. What's the eyeball for? Something watching me? Much happening yet in this first episode. There we go. Broken clock, how convenient. Watch, I bet none of the clocks in this game are gonna be working or on time. think I'm gonna try and leave this video as unedited as I can, just to kind of make it more raw, more filling for you guys. I think I might want to go check out that truck that was back here before we take off.
Carl knew straight away where to find the infuriated Gilles Lachance. Any good investigation would have to start there. Carl felt that the store and its surroundings still held their secrets, and he didn't like to miss out.
No,
that had to be the worst parking job ever.
Right?
Who was Carl to judge, though? It may be customary to park like that around these parts. Or not.
Or not. Is this settled? I don't think so. Alright. Let's go this way.
Carl wondered what the hell could that thing be. It looked like a man fossilized in ice.
Huh. Oh shit.
All of a sudden, Carl felt like he was pulled inside a world of dreams, a cold, unknown dimension. Somehow, self-control was slipping from his grasp. Appearances, this was a hunting log. Better yet, a war diary.
Huh. Well, I want to keep that. How do I keep that? Oh, well.
What could these engraved numbers mean?
739.
A fresh path suddenly appeared before Carl.
739.
That feeling you get when you immerse your frozen hands in hot water. What happened? Now at least he knew who the unfortunate man petrified in ice was. Gilles Lachance, the general store's manager himself.
Anything else in this truck? So anything that I do in that reverse world, I guess, happens in the real world?
The Polaroid, Carl's long-standing and faithful ally, had seen a share of husbands caught red-handed cheating.
Oh, shit.
There's always something out there waiting to be snapped away.
Huh. Because he had a gun in that little cutscene, I'd like to have that gun. Fix it. Check this outhouse. Might be something in there. No. Let's follow these real quick. It's probably gonna lead to that ice guy, but... What the hell was that? Scared me. Oh, it just leads to him. Okay. Let's check this camp again.
It was so cold, already Carl did not feel his toes anymore.
Let's take these. Alright, well, I think this is a good place to leave off this video. Experienced a lot in this. I'm really enjoying this game, I'd love to record some more of it. And if you guys want to see more of this game, or another game, just let me know, and I'll do it. Talk to you guys in the next video.